big question in our lab is to understand why the sensory hair cells in the ear fail to regenerate when we lose them. And losing hair cells for humans means losing hearing. And this is a very common phenomenon. Most people start losing their hearing in their late 20s, and by the time they're retirement age, there's, you know, more than 50% of the people in the country have a significant hearing loss. And so the problem of hearing loss really stems from the loss of these small sensory hair cells, as they're called. They don't have anything to do with hair, but that's what they're called because they have these little fingers that come up from their top surface. And these bend in response to sound coming into the ear. And when they bend, they send a signal into the brain that tells you you're hearing something. And those cells are born while you're still in utero, and you are born with all of those cells that you'll ever have. So their loss means that you're permanently deaf for a particular frequency or particular sound. Humans tend to lose their hearing as a result of environmental problems. So loud noises will kill these hair cells. They're very sensitive cells. They're among the more sensitive cells in your body. So as I said, loud noise will kill them, but other things that you do to your body will kill them as well. For instance, taking certain antibiotics that are extremely helpful when you're very sick can nonetheless cause these hair cells to die. Finding ways to preserve the hair cells is actually part of the project that we work on in the lab, trying to find drugs that will allow these very effective agents like antibiotics and chemotherapy agents to do their work, but at the same time protect these hair cells from the side effects of those drugs is another project in the lab. But the main focus is to try and understand the developmental biology of the inner ear, of the sensory cells of the inner ear, so that we can better understand this failure of regeneration. The RMI awards were meant to stimulate collaboration between labs within USC to generate new ideas and new progress in stem cell research. In this particular case, we were lucky enough to get one, and the group is a collaboration between three people who haven't worked together before: Justin Ichida and Taka Ohyama and myself. And those the focus of this grant is to try and understand how to make the cells of the inner ear, which are very specialized and complex cells, and that normally arise once during development and then don't never regenerate. We're really excited about the prospects.